Section 3.5 is called derivatives of trigonometric functions. The first part of 3.5 goes to special trig limits. These are two limits that you should memorize. And the first one is the limit as x approaches 0 of sine of x over x equals. We did this one using the squeeze theorem earlier this year. The limit as x approaches 0 of cosine x minus 1. Your book uses these two limits to actually come up with the derivative using the long form of the derivative. Find the derivative of sine of x and cosine of x. I'm not going to make you responsible for producing those two derivatives. I recommend through their derivation on page 5 and six. So there, you do need to be able to use these two limit functions. I'm going to use those two limit functions with the example 1 that's on page 4. To do both parts here. The first one is they want the limit as x approaches 0, the sine of 4x over x. Okay. Now, if this bottom was a 4x, I know my answer would be. So, Mr. Taylor's first rule of math, if something's not the way you like it, make it that way. Well, I can make that a 4x, but in order to divide something by 4, I also have to multiply. What I did is I now have this new limit. I'm going to pull this 4 out in front of the limit. X approaches 0, sine of 4x over 4x, which is equal to 4 times 1, which is 2. Not just tell me that the answer is 4. Okay. Like the sine of 6x over x would be 6. The sine of 8x over x would be 8. I do, if I'm asking this problem on a quiz or a test, I do need to see one step, hey, you're multiplying. Or bring the 4 out in front. The second one is want the limit of sine of 3x over the sine of 5x. I am going to take this. I cannot directly do problem the way it's written. The signs don't cancel, the x's don't cancel. Okay, that's not the way to do this problem. What I can do is I can divide the top and the bottom by x. What that's going to do is it's going to give me the limit as x approaches 0, the sine of 3x over x all over sine 5x for x. Okay, on the top, this is very similar to the last example we did. Well, I'd want a 3x down here. So to compensate for that, I'm going to put a 3 up there. Bottom, denominator, I want 5x here. I am going to pull the 3/5 out in front of my limit. 3/5 times the limit as x approaches 0. Of now, I have the sine of x over 3x all over the sine of 5x over 5x. I can now take the limits. This goes to 1. This goes to 1. End up with 1 fifths, which is just fifths. Again, if I'm asking you this problem on a quiz or a test, I do need to see all the works spelled out here. Do not this. Limit of x approaches 0. Sine of 3x over the 5x. Don't do this. That is wrong. Okay. You'll get the right answer, but you won't get any credit because your work is not valid math. So those are the two limits of the trig functions and the derivatives of sine and cosine. And we're just going to write down those derivative of the sine of x equal to the cosine of x, and the derivative cosine of x is equal to the opposite of sine of x. These are two that you need to memorize. You are going to be using them frequently. Remember when we had an entire half of a year last year that was trig? Well, do a lot of derivatives that involve. So I'm going to do some examples. I'm not going to do all of example 2, parts of it. Parts B and part B tells us why. To the sine of x, x cosine x. It wants to find y prime. Well, this first part, the derivative is straightforward. It is just cosine of x. Minus this second part is a product rule. First function, derivative of the second. Plus the second function times the derivative of the first. And to simplify this, I'm going to distribution. Get cosine x. Minus times a minus is a plus. So I get a plus x sine x. Minus cosine x. That is just going to equal 2 after those become 0. So we're going to be, why we did the product rule last time, we could use it like this. What I am going to do is it says y is 1 plus the sine of x. Over 1 minus the sine of x. And it is low d high, high d. And away we go. I prime is bottom function minus times the derivative of the top. The derivative of 1 is 0. Derivative of cosine. Minus top function. Plus the. Times the derivative of the bottom. 0 Derivative of sine is cosine. And then denominator squared is 1 minus the sine of x squared. I'm going to continue multiply some stuff out, see what we get. We get cosine x minus sine x cosine x minus of a minus plus cosine x, then a minus of a minus is a plus x cosine x. Over minus sine of x squared. Negative sine x cosine x, positive sine x cosine x cancel. Have two cosines of x over 1 minus sine of x. So that's examples of using the derivatives of sine and cosine. The other trig functions that we need to be able to find the derivative are that is equal to the secant, cotangent. Negative and derivative is the derivative cosecant. Negative I'm going to go ahead and put sine and cosine back on here. X. Cosine of x. It's expected that you have all six of these memorized. You memorize the ones that are on the left. The ones on the right are the derivatives of their cofunctions. And the derivatives of the cofunctions are just the opposites or the negative of the cofunctions of the derivatives on the left. So cotangent is the cofunction of tangent. So the derivative of cotangent is the opposite of the cofunction of secant squared, which would be it is expected that you have these memorized. There's six more that are going to be on your benchmark test. I will try to get the benchmark test to you Wednesday, that the derivatives that you know we don't have them all yet. Just give some starts. So I'm going to do some example problems for you. Your homework, like your homework. Your first problem on your work is 12. Hint, you're going to want to factor greater on 12. I'm going to do 15. 15, yeah, so 15 will kind of set you up to the limit problem. I want the limit x approaches of the sine x over x. I'm going to rewrite the denominator. We get the limit x approaches 2 x minus. X squared minus 4 is x minus 2 times x plus 2. Go back and look at this limit. Limit x approaches 0 of sine x equals. I'm going to instead of saying x approaches 0, the limit of the sine of 0 over 0 equals. Okay? If we look at the left hand side of this limit here, I have the sine of a number that's approaching 0 over a number that is approaching 0. This part right here just be 1. I'm allowed to put the 2 into the second part. I'm going to get 1. That should help you out. 12 and 16, I gave you hints. Your next one is 26. I'm going to do 28. Y is x sine of x. Over 1 plus cos. Okay, now this one I got to be careful because I'm going to have to use both the product rule and the quotient rule. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do O I minus I O for denominator. So the bottom function, 1 plus the cosine. The derivative of the top is a product rule. First function, derivative of the second, plus the second function, times the derivative of the first. So that gives me this is my O, I, minus I, sine X, the derivative of the low. The derivative of 1 is 0. Derivative of cosine x is negative. All over 1 plus. Now we're going to want to distribute and then do some simplification. 1 times this stuff over here is just going to be this here. So I'm going to. Plus sine x. Cosine x times the stuff on the right is going to give me x cosine squared x. Sine x sine x. On the right, I get negative of a negative is a positive. Negative x positive. All over 1 plus cosine of x all squared. Now I'm going to look at what I have here. Make sure I did the distribution correctly. X cosine x I'm going to look at something here. X squared cosine x plus x squared sine of x. Not x squared. X cosine squared x, x sine. Notice I could pull an x out of both of those. Give me x times cosine squared x plus sine. From last year, cosine squared x plus sine squared x is 1. So these two terms just leave me with an x. Those two terms become an x. Just trying to see if there's anything else. All right, x cosine x. I'm going to put the plus x here. I'm going to put plus sine cosine x. Sine x cosine x sine x. All over 1 plus squared. The reason why I did this is I put parentheses around these two and parentheses around these two. I can pull out common factors. Out. This group, I can pull out an x. That is going to leave me with cosine x plus 1. Out of this group, I can pull a sine of x out. I can pull out a cosine x plus 1. Over 1 plus cosine of x. Notice that cosine of x plus 1 is the same thing as 1 plus the cosine of x. So I can cancel one of these in the denominator with that common factor. My final answer, problem, x, the sine of x, over 1. Okay. Your next problem you have is 44. They want you to do second derivatives. That means after you take the first derivative, you take the derivative. So you have problem 44. I am going to 3. I want to find y double prime, y. So first derivative equal to the first function times the derivative of the second plus the second function times the derivative of the first. Second derivative would just be taking the derivative of the first derivative. What's the first function times the derivative of the second, which would be negative. Plus the, I'm still on this first part, plus the second function. The derivative of the first. On the right-hand side, part in, it is the first function. The derivative of the second. Plus the second function. The derivative of the first. Now I can simplify it. I have a negative e to the x sine of x and a positive e to the x sine of x that will go away. I have 2 e to the x. And your last problem is, you are matching graphs of functions, their derivative. So you want, I would do is, it's going to be a refresher. Hey, do you remember what graphs look like? This is one I want you to go ahead and use Desmos or whatever you need to, just so you can understand what the graphs of those trig functions look like. That is it for 3.5, which is the last of our material for test one. Test one is scheduled to be given on Wednesday the 16th and Thursday the 17th. If you have any questions, let me know and we'll be ready for that.